All right, so 3.20 is here, and with it comes some pretty serious changes to our options and settings. So this video we're going to do a little bit differently. This is on a fresh install, and I'm going to go through this as if I was setting it up for the very first time. I think that'll be actually pretty helpful for those watching, so we're going to go ahead and do that right now. So first things first, before we even start playing, we go to our options, and we're going to go to the game settings tab. We're going to start turning off junk that we don't need. So these are what I personally use, and this is for mouse and keyboard. So let's get started. Let's see, hints I always turn off, control hints I turn off, I'm not a noob, rest of the stuff I don't worry about, sprint toggle, no, let's see, crouch toggle, prone toggle, no, aimed sound sights toggle, yes, I always turn that on, I don't like to hold down right click. Everything else here looks fine by default. Here's where we start getting into some serious changes. G-safe defaults on, no, we don't want that. Proximity assist defaults on, no, we don't want that. And everything else is whatever. I don't care too much about those. So scrolling down, this is another big change here. ESP zone size degrees. I like this up to 20. ESP damaging curvature. You could do 1.10. I sometimes leave it at that. Or sometimes I knock it up to 1.25. But for this, I think I'm going to go with 1.0. So I'm going to put this down to 1.0. Because I've been playing with that recently. Scrolling down, VJoy, yaw in degrees, this is the big one, this is important. This goes down to 4 all the way to the left. Pitch goes down to 4 all the way to the left. Dead zone, down to 0, we don't want that. Velocity indicator, we want on. Yes, always on, this is very important. That's what shows you where you're going in space, and where your ship is moving. This I don't really touch, I do however turn off the dead zone, because I'm not a big fan of dead zones at all on mouse and keyboard. Same thing here, turret ESP, zone size, we leave that alone. Let's scroll down. Nothing here so far. Here we go, spaceship gimbal mode default is on auto. Gimbals suck, I put this to fixed. Same with the vehicle ground weapons, set those to fixed as well. I ignore all these, I leave those alone as they are. Scrolling down, I leave the pips on lead. I don't really worry that too much. Nope, everything else I keep leaving alone here. Yes, this is the awful stuff. Alright, so vehicle targeting enables auto zoom on lock target. No, we don't want that. Targeting max auto zoom level, none. I don't care if the thing is turned off, I still, for redundancy, lower these sliders down to the left. Pilot look ahead enabled, absolutely not. Get this crap out of here. We don't want any of this stuff. It's not good. Turret look ahead enabled. No. No, 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 no. All to the left here. Driver is set to default. No. But I don't trust it, so... all to the left. Oh, yes. We definitely don't want this either. Pilot driver is set to no. Good. G-force induced head movement. No, we don't want that. Get rid of that. Global camera shake? Absolutely not. Get rid of that as well. And everything else is looking okay, except for this. Emissions HUD display signature values. I always put that on to yes. I like to see the numerical signatures on my HUD. All right, now the game settings out of the way, we're going to go over the graphics. This is purely based on what your computer can handle. So I'm just going to set mine up as I set mine up. HDR experimental is new. I can't handle this because my monitor doesn't support it, so I leave that alone. Let's see, quality. I like to crank this up because I got a nice computer. However, it's not nice enough to run volumetric cloud, so off those go. Field of view, I always put mine up to about 90. I find that to be the nice, happy medium. Motion blur, I turn that crap off. Sharpening, I crank up. And aberrations, I get rid of because aberrations sound like D&D monsters, and that doesn't sound cool to me. Fill grain also goes down to no. And session information QR code, no. We're not shopping. We don't need QR codes. We turn that off too. Under audio, I always turn the music volume off. It's by default on, but for this video, I had it turned off so you didn't hear it playing in the background. Let's see. What else do I do? Audio-driven camera shake strength. No, that's bad. Bad, get rid of that. And yeah, we're done with this one. So let's move on over to controls. For me here, controls, I drop this down to about 5. This is how I like to play. My sensitivity is very low. My DPI for my mouse is 800. So my mouse sensitivity in game is set to 5. Then everything else here I leave as is. Right, so I don't touch too much here. This is a lot of quality of life stuff I like to do. Under vehicles cockpit, I like to do open all doors. I usually set that to semicolon and close all doors. I'll set to apostrophe. I like doing that. And let's be open and closed door, especially for doing dropship stuff. It's very handy. I'll go to vehicles targeting. Everything here I tend to leave as is, except for entering remote turrets. Here we go. So for entering remote turrets, there's only two options currently. Is a remote turret 1 or remote turret 2. That's typically in the A2. So I like to set this up to insert for the first one and delete for the second one. That way I can easily swap between those two remote turrets. But other than that, I tend to leave everything alone here under vehicles targeting. So under vehicles and weapons, the only change I really make here is to set my lag and lead pip to a toggle. I like that, so I set it to control, right control to be specific. That way I can just kind of swap between the two as needed. Other than that, I tend to leave everything alone here for the most part. Vehicle shields and countermeasures. This is a pretty important one. By default, you launch your flares with H and your noise with J. I don't like that, so I like to set mine to mouse button 4 for my flares or decoys, and my noise I set to button 5 on my mouse. It feels way better to do it this way, trust me. Vehicle power triangle assignments. These are pretty big, so this is probably the most important. By default, the keybinds suck, so we're going to set these to good ones. So for weapons, set the max. Set it once, I always do 1. This puts my weapons to max. For my engines, set the max. I like to do this with 3. So 1 for weapons, 3 for engines. And for shields, set the max. I like to do 2. If for whatever reason you like to set it back to default, you could do reset assignments as F8. That's good enough. However, if you really want to, I do this too. I set it to 4. It overwrites some things, but I don't really use those anyway. So, 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's like playing an MMO. And that's it. We are set up and ready to go play. So, I hope you guys enjoy 3.20, and I hope this video was helpful to you.